All right, the property show is also about good community living, so it's time to give you insights into some initiatives across the country brought to you by Common Flow. Bangalore, citizens are up in arms about the haphazard dumping of garbage and government apathy to enforcing proper management of solid waste. But there's a silver lining. Where the government is failing, citizens are stepping up to do their bit. Lakshmi Sividas captures a great community initiative which can serve as an example across the country.
These are the residents of DSR Heights that Bangalore can be proud of. They have succeeded in managing a critical aspect of urban life, which the city governing bodies have failed to do. The residents of this apartment complex have drastically brought down waste produced by the homes here by composting the waste.
We took this drive within the campus. We initiated it with some stickers like these. We went door to door. We had a group of around 10 to 15 volunteers. We had to educate each one of them, the causes, the benefits that they would get by getting into waste aggregation.
The efforts of this group of residents has paid off, and big time. The average household at DSR Heights now produces a little less than 100 grams of waste a day, down from nearly 2 kilograms before segregation.
We collect the wet waste every day. The dry waste happens 3 days. That's Monday, Wednesday and Saturday. Sanitary and wet waste go every day. The housekeeping staff comes, collects, takes a bin. They put the wet waste in their bin, bring it here. They decompose it. We take the manure, put it for our plants.
Citizens' initiatives like DSR's to control waste is significant. It comes at a time when Bangalore is reeling under a garbage crisis. As of December 1st, the BBMP has stopped dumping at one of the city's largest landfills, Mandur, following protests from residents, leaving several lakh tons of waste on their hands and few options to dispose of it. Experts say that a majority of this waste is produced by residential houses.
Out of 4 to 5,000 tons that are produced, close to 50% is produced by residential complexes or residential needs. 20% comes from your halls, hotels, party functions. 20% comes from your commercial and the rest from other sources.
To fix matters, the BBMP had also come out with rules indicating that it would levy fines of up to 50,000 rupees on apartment complexes that fail to segregate waste. But the rule has never been implemented. While the people's initiative to segregate waste at source could help alleviate problems, experts say even this will be in vain unless the BBMP staff themselves are trained to handle waste management effectively.
Here you need more softer training, more hand-holding, and 50% of your problem can go away. BBMP collectors who come in, they are not trained, neither their vehicles have separate compartments to get this waste. So majority of the cases, we have heard these apartments complaining, we put so much effort, and what happened? Again, they have just mixed up everything else.
If private citizens can do their part, then the government should be leading the way. One can only hope that the PM Swachh Bharat campaign will force the civic administration to train its staff to safely dispose of the city's waste. From Bengaluru, Lakshmi Sivdas for NDTV.
We are now joined by a dynamic thinker and doer, Ravi Kumar, Director BPAC. Ravi has given up his plush banker's job to take up relevant social causes, and solid waste management is right at the top of his list. Ravi, thanks so much for joining us. It's becoming increasingly clear that the government can't do it alone. Communities and citizens have to be engaged in waste management efforts, isn't it?
City like Bangalore generates around 4,500 tons of garbage every day. And it's becoming more difficult for municipalities to handle. The water landfills that they built 10, 15 years ago is running out of its capacity, and we can't keep building more landfills. The best thing is for citizens to take up initiative of segregating waste at source. Once you segregate your waste, all the dry waste can go to recycling industry, and the wet waste can be converted into compost, biogas, and things like that. Ultimately, by doing this, the volume of waste going to landfill reduces drastically.
Could you cite a few other examples of citizen initiatives in waste management across the country and including Bangalore?
We have been handling waste for Manyata Tech Park. They have set up a 2-ton capacity plant. A lot of companies segregate the waste and give the compost, wet waste to us. We are composting them. So there are many such initiatives across Bangalore which is now taking up.
What are the other easily doable options of waste management in the country?
More than 60 to 70% of waste that we generate is organic in nature. This waste, organic waste, can be either converted into compost, is going to go back to farmlands, or you convert that into a biogas. Through biogas, you use the gas directly for your cooking and things like that. If not, feed that into a generator, generate electricity, use it for this thing. And now there are many companies which have come up with vehicles which can run on biogas. There is a recent initiative taken by BMTC, Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation, they're tying up with a company in Singapore, where they're proposing to generate gas out of municipal waste and run all the Volvo buses in city.
Ravi, thanks very much for joining us today and giving us that perspective.